In this video, we will be demonstrating the potential and kinetic energy kit, the ES9, in the engineering science range from TecQuipment. With this kit, students can practically learn the difference between potential and kinetic energy and how it can change from one to another using a pendulum or a flywheel. In addition, you can also see and measure the elastic potential energy in a spring and examine Hooke's law. Throughout this video, we are going to look at three experiments in this kit, which are energy in a spring, energy in a pendulum, and energy in a flywheel. First up, let's have a look at what is included. As with all the kits in the engineering science range, it comes in a sturdy plastic box with a clear lid containing the bits and pieces needed to carry out the experiments. First, we're going to look at the energy in a spring experiment to understand Hooke's law. This law, in summary, says that if you test a spring in the elastic region, the extension or compression is directly proportional to the force. A spring is mounted on the frame. You add weights to the weight hanger from 100 grams through to 500 grams attached to the end of the spring and measure the load. Then take the scale reading from the magnetic ruler and calculate the extension. Plotting the data on a graph allows you to look at the gradient and examine the load and extension relationship. There's another procedure involving the spring using the plummet arm mounted on the side where you hook the spring on. You add weights at much smaller increments of 10 grams until the weight hanger just touches the desk surface when it's released. Then you do the same, moving the plummet arm 20 millimeters up the work panel, calculating the results to examine if potential energy stored in the raised mass matches the energy stored in the spring for each different drop height. Next, we move on to examining energy in a pendulum. In theory, a pendulum will swing forever, but it loses energy to the air as it moves. The experiment involves releasing the pendulum at a set height and allowing it to swing freely from side to side, then measuring and recording how many seconds it takes to complete 50 swings for each height, looking at different cord lengths. By examining the results, you can see the relationship between the potential energy and the kinetic energy. The final experiment in this kit looks at a flywheel to prove the theory of kinetic energy, with the energy being stored in the flywheel. Mounted near the top with a weight hanger like this, first start with a total of 100 grams. That's 9 of the 10 gram masses, including the weight hanger itself, which is another 10 grams. By slowly turning the flywheel to lift the weight hanger until it reaches 280 millimeters on the ruler, you then let go and use the stopwatch to measure how many seconds it takes to fall back down to zero and back up to its maximum height. You can now calculate the potential energy and potential energy loss, along with the kinetic energy for the flywheel. You should note that the heavier the mass, the larger the potential energy loss up to a certain point. The guidance, student workbook, and experiment explanations within the manual pack provide all the theory, equations, tables, and graphs for plotting and in-depth details on how to perform the experiments. For more information on the potential energy and kinetic energy kit, click on the links below. You can also find more details on all of the 18 kits in the engineering science range. Hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the TecQuipment YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.